Good evening. I'm Mark Herman. Welcome to the Embassy Theater. Here in my hometown of Fort Wayne, Indiana, it's wonderful to come back here. Even though I live out west, this is home, and it's really wonderful to come to a place that I connect with so deeply. This is the very first theater pipe organ I ever played when Bob Goldstein and Dine Pfeffenberger and Bob Ort opened this place up to a group of youngsters interested in pipe organs. And I was the only kid who sat down and played the Darktown Strutter's Ball, an old 1920s tune, and I think they realized that maybe I would be a good fit for instruments like this. So this theater is a very special place, and it's going through a bit of a tough time right now. We're in a pandemic, and obviously getting together in massive groups of people has been something we've had to figure out how that's going to be done now. And they've done an amazing job here at the theater figuring out ways to actually start having some events again. So we're doing a campaign to raise the curtain once again, and I hope that you will take a look at the link in the description of the video and consider a donation towards helping the embassy meet that goal. To start off there, we had There's No Business Like Show Business, and certainly there isn't. And you may have even heard a few strains of Back Home Again in Indiana because, well, I am. And next up, we're going to go to a novelty tune that I think works really well on this organ. And it displays, you'll hear one of the most unique sounds of the organ, something called a crumkin. It sounds like bottled bees, but very intense. It's a very bright and fun sound, and you'll hear it in this song called Dainty Miss. Next, I'm going to play a song from the pen of Johnny Green. Johnny Green was really an amazing guy. By the time he was in his early 20s, he already wrote several hit songs, the most famous being Body and Soul, which has become a torch standard. But he worked his way up to become the music director for MGM Studios, doing orchestrations and arrangements and conducting and on and on and on. He was just an amazing guy. But this song, I think, is my favorite of all of his compositions, and it was used in a film by the same title called I Cover the Waterfront. And this song is just great in how relaxed it is. It just puts you at ease, and this organ puts me at ease because it's just so gorgeous and lyrical, and I hope you enjoy this.
Thank you.
while back, some people suggested that I should play more new music on the theater organ. I am in love with music of the 20s, the 30s, the 40s, all of this great stuff that I think I was introduced to mostly by watching Looney Tunes as a kid. And it really is great and catchy music and lyrical. And some of the stuff you hear on the radio today doesn't exactly lend itself to pipe organ. It's maybe just not the obvious transfer. However, I decided, well, I want to do something new. So I wrote this piece myself, and it's in the style of a 1920s novelty piece, but the subject is something near and dear to me. It's about our dog, Jarvis. He's an Airedale Terrier, full of life and energy and occasionally mischief, and I tried to write a song that would capture all of those traits and in one nice little package. So here we go, Jarvis. I talked about the song I Cover the Waterfront being a nice, relaxed, and easygoing song. This next song fits that same profile. It's a piece of music that I was introduced to by Simon Gledhill when I heard him play it here at the Embassy a long time ago. And it's just always been a favorite of mine. It's called Two Cigarettes in the Dark. Thank you. Now it's time for some music from Broadway. I've been listening to lots of musical theater lately. I love musical theater, and whether it's Sondheim or Richard Rodgers or Jerome Kern, I really like a lot of it. And it's been sad not being able to go see, you know, Broadway at the Embassy, Broadway in New York City. I think everybody needs to see theater, and it's certainly some of the best entertainment that you can go see. Right now, I'm going to go back in time to the 1940s to what was considered at the time the first modern Broadway show, and of course, it's gone on to become a classic. The show is Oklahoma by Rodgers and Hammerstein. There are lots and lots of fun songs. You have Surrey with the Fringe on Top, Poor Judd is Dead, Many a New Day, The Farmer and the Cowman. It just kind of goes on and on. Oh, What a Beautiful Morning. And every single song is a hit. And it was a bit of a challenge to figure out what to leave out, because I could just sit here for 2 hours and play music from Oklahoma and to cover everything. But I've sort of pared it down, and some of them are not complete songs, they're just references. But one of the guys on the organ crew earlier was singing all the lyrics to one of the songs. And I didn't realize there were multiple verses, but there were, and he knew them all. And it just shows you how catchy this stuff is. So here we go with some music from Oklahoma.
Thank you.
This theater has a long history of theater organists being around it. Back in the 1950s, they did a reopening when they rebranded the theater from the M. Boyd Theater to the Embassy Theater. And one of the big features was Buddy Nolan at the Grand Page organ. And he became quite a fixture here at the theater and was one of the people who helped lead the campaign to save it in the 1970s from the wrecking ball. He was also a composer. He wrote some really nice songs, and I thought I'd play one of those right now. And I'd really like to dedicate this to Tom and Penny Matheson, who have been so kind to sponsor this event tonight. And it's just a gorgeous song, and it has lyrics, which I will not sing. But if anybody's interested in learning more about it, I'm happy to share the music with anybody who wants a copy. Here is Probably. If you liked that song by Buddy Nolan, you should know that there are a few CDs that have recently been produced featuring this instrument that were newly recorded just about a year ago. And there's one by myself, one by Richard Hills, a phenomenal theater organist from London, and also one of all sorts of vintage Buddy Nolan recordings. And there's a promotion running because of this event, and it's that if you decide to send in a donation of $100, you get one of my CDs as a gift. And if you send in $200, you get one of Richard's as well. And for $300, you can get all three of the sets. And maybe you've already bought them. And wouldn't it be wonderful to introduce this page to some of your friends and pass those on to others? Anyway, this entire theater, this wonderful space, was saved by theater organ enthusiasts, led by Buddy Nolan and Bob Goldstein and several others. And it's always nice to see the love that comes to this building because of this organ. And also, I've been so impressed with all of the staff and the community around this place. They all realize what a special gem this instrument is. And I also have to thank the volunteer organ crew who comes in here every week and makes sure that this thing is absolutely in the top condition it can possibly be in. And they've helped out on a number of other projects as well around here. It's really a great group of guys. So I send my thanks to all of them. It's a great group. Next up, a piece of music that I think needs no introduction, really. But for those of you who live in Fort Wayne, you might be able to guess which high school I went to, because this was the fight song. It's When the Saints Go Marching In. Well, it's been an absolute honor to come back here to my home theater to play for you, but sadly, it's that time to close the program for the evening. although it's certainly an interesting experience to perform to a digital audience and a virtual audience, I look out here at these 2,500 seats that are empty, and trust me, this organ sounds so much better in the phenomenal acoustics of this theater. So I do look forward to the day when we can all be back together and listening to this organ in person. And I encourage you to keep track of what the Embassy is doing. They are starting to do events again and doing it in a very different way. They certainly can't have 2,500 people in here all at once, but I encourage you to keep track of what they're up to. They've been doing an incredible job. To close this evening's program, this is a piece of music that is very much associated with this theater. Buddy Nolan wrote this to play every time that he took the console down into the orchestra pit before a show began. And it's very dramatic, and there's no better way to end a program here but with Buddy Nolan's Embassy Theme.